got fucking nervous.
The time has come.
Always excited to play.
This is Travis, drummer of Blink 182. I like Cadillacs. I like music. I don't know, I don't look too far ahead. I look maybe like 2 months ahead. I'm kind of like live fast, die fun. In my free time, I build cars, I play in other bands, run a company, that's all. If we're fucked up, you're to blame. I got my knuckles done, I got my wife's name on the side of my neck, and then I got live fast, die fun. I think it goes like in stages. Like the first 3 weeks I'll do the same thing, then the next 2 weeks I'll do the same thing, and then you know the last parts of the tour I'll just kind of like wing it and do extra stuff, just you know add stuff just for fun, for the sake of keeping things like fresh and exciting or whatever. We really need to see this through. We never wanted to be abused. We'll never give up. It's no use if we're fucked up. To blame.
I did this Modern Drummer article. I got all this stuff this year. I got like Drummer of the Year and whatever. So I do these interviews, and they ask me like, "Are you a punk drummer?" And I'd go, "I don't consider myself a punk drummer." So then when you read the article, it goes, "I refuse to be called a punk." Like you know, switched all my words around. But no, I grew up playing jazz and like funk, fusion, Latin, a bunch of stuff. We really need.
I've got lots of cars. I've got, I just bought a new 54 Cadillac. I had a 53 Cadillac, 66, 70, 60, and 77. So that keeps me busy.
This is my baby though. This is my second Cadillac.
Hey, I got a present for Travis. Hold on. This is the pick I used last night.
Here you go.
What, dude? What?
I am Tom DeLonge, but it should be DeLonge, because I went to France, and they said, you're pronouncing it wrong. I'm all DeLonge. They're like, no, it is DeLonge. And I was like, fuck yeah, that sounds rad. My name's not Tom. My name is Thomas. You know? No one named me Tom. They named me Thomas. It's Thomas DeLonge. Now that sounds fucking cooler. Tom DeLonge rhymes. Tom DeLonge. It sounds like a really weird fucking microphone echoing through a train station. Tom DeLonge.
Yossi, how do you like it, the camera?
Yeah, how you like it?
Yeah,
how you like it? I leave my closet door open all night. I know the CIA would say, what you hear is all you're saying.
Yeah, I love to dance. That's why you're here tonight, isn't it, gentlemen? I did a lot of dance and stuff, but it was more like freestyle dance. It's kind of like a more punk rock thing, and I used to get some crowds on that. So I used to get like 20 to 30 million people every single show.
I'm not like you guys. I'm not like you.
Don't touch his hand. Don't touch his hand. Don't do it. Don't do it. Jessica, do not do it. Not, oh my god.
Oh, now you've got it.
Yes, you know me.
There's a lot of stuff on the internet, but it takes too long. And it's just it's a lot of creepy stuff that Tom looks at, like lots of men on men, sexual kind of things.
I like to look at men pooping in other men's mouths.
Oh yeah, motherfucker!
I believe in unicorns. Well, I do. I mean, who doesn't? I mean, it's like a horse with a seat on top of its head.
I'm gonna fucking rock so hard tonight, like the craziest, gnarliest rocking you've ever seen.
Let's see you stretch.
Ow!
I got gas.
Ah! Ah!
Might be in Florida, but I'm bringing the spirit.
You're bringing the San Diego spirit.
Here comes Glory Hog.
Is there a camera over here? You got a camera?
My name's Mark. I ride a scooter. I'm badass.
He has a chemical imbalance.
That is so scary looking.
Oh. Young and stupid, left wide open, hearts are wasted, lives are broken.
Stop, man, I'm having diarrhea, man.
Hi, my name is Mark, and I play bass and I sing in Blink-182.
I go like this, and Nick Tischler, the tush tickler, gets it done for me.
Am I afraid of bees? No. Why?
Ha! Oh, a bee!
And I ate some food. I had more diarrhea. I've had a lot of diarrhea since I got here. Something's nice. Wrong. Hi, diarrhea.
Tom's one of my best friends. I think he's really nice, and I think he's good to the animals.
Whoa, film me again, fucking asshole.
I want to go on record right now as saying, like, I just love oral sex, just in general.
Life has changed a lot since the first Urethra Chronicles video. We've toured a lot more, we've been a lot more places. We've been lucky with our band and had some success. But we're still pretty much exactly the same people as we were before. We're just lame individuals that you'd be embarrassed to introduce your friends to.
I don't know, there's a whole bunch of difference, you know? I mean, we were playing music then and I was touring, and I don't really like let, you know, if we have a single out or if we're really popular at the time, like, I don't know. That stuff doesn't really matter to me.
She makes me feel like it's raining outside. And when the storm's gone, I'm all torn up inside. I'm always not.
In 10 years, I will have a degree.
7 times 8. 7 times 8 is 48.
And I will be running for the presidency of the United States of America. And I will be on TV trying to tell people that I'm not insane.
That's the special ball bonus program.
because they will have interviews like this one on the TV and saying, don't let this guy be president.
Every once in a while, I like to fuck pigs.
That video, what I just did right there, is what's going to stop me from becoming president.
But I'm going to fucking tell everyone about aliens. And aliens are going to show up and be all, thanks, Tom. Fuck, no one knew about it. No one knew who we were, you know? But you totally told everybody, thank you so much. And I'd be like, dude, no problem, aliens. You know? You're laughing at. This is real shit.
Tom's been studying UFOs for a long time. And he reads a lot about it. He does a lot of study on the internet. He's gone out, I know, to Area 51 to try and see UFOs. And he believes that they're there.
I took a ticket and cooperatively together look for lights in the sky.
Right when we left our hotel, a bunch of black cars and police cars came up, you know, a bunch of Secret Service guys jumped out, and then like a Navy Admiral, but that guy knows about fucking UFOs.
I don't know if aliens exist or not. I'll say, actually, you know what, I'll say no, just to anger Tom. He can bring me all the proof in the world, and I'll just go, nah, I don't believe it.
What would happen if aliens really came down, dude? That'd be fucked up. Aliens, dude. You're hanging out, we're all having a burrito, and aliens come. It's like that's not like a normal fucking thing that happens, you know? So people go, yeah. Is it gonna be a weird thing? Yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Yeah, let's go Christmas shopping. There's only a couple weeks left to... Oh my God, there's a fucking ship. And these aliens are, whoa, they come out. They're like... Fuck, we've just been listening to some Blink and wondering what you guys are doing. And they'll be like, all right, well, fuck, we're just going to cruise over to Vegas and, you know, and go gambling and whatnot, you know? And we'll be all right, aliens. You guys have fun, you know? Go to, like, the Bellagio. We hear that's really nice, you know? And the aliens are all right. Fuck, we'll probably go to Bellagio then because they know who we are because, you know, you told everyone.
What are we
listen,
doing?
Wait, listen.
We're doing the Billboard Music Awards.
Hey, we're not up for an award, are we?
No.
Oh, hell fucking no.
You're both married, and you both got married kind of at when you could be getting the most of the...
Badge.
You know, in vagina snatch.
No, so when we found girls that liked us, we fucking sealed the deal.
Yeah.
And we made it, we sealed the deal to a point to where if they want to leave us, they have to go find a judge and an attorney. I'm like fucking, I'm almost a Navy SEAL just by sitting like this.
As a SEAL, you must be serious. You took an oath to defend the Constitution, United States of America, to kill and not to be killed, to die, not to be died.
Look at you, dude. Tell me you'll go down and gamble one hand right now.
They'll throw me in
no,
jail.
They won't.
No.
They can't throw you in jail, dude. Oh. Hi.
Hello.
Look, can they throw him in jail for going out of the casino looking like this?
Oh!
Really? Why? Really?
I had like the gnarliest training. I actually had to have sex with a SEAL. To get into the SEALs.
Motherfucker! Out. Get down! You son of a bitch here!
That's what happens, that's what happens. We are going to the very first shot for us in this video. As a concept is wasting money on other things besides a big nice video, we're just going to break cars and break TVs and buy homeless people food and whatever, I don't know.
Hey, look at me!
I hope to God we don't fucking die.
I hope he dies. Well, actually, it was a lot of fun because we got to shoot it like, you know, like a skateboard video, which is our whole intention because we all grew up skateboarding. And we liked the idea of doing it just on digital video and running around and just doing whatever.
We're in Hollywood. There's the fucking Capitol Records building right here. Right behind the palace right now. We just hooked up a homeless guy. We're going to send him through a day spa.
You know what, honestly? You can't even tell.
Gave people money and people didn't want the money because they thought they had to I don't know, they got scared when people just run up to you and hand you money. They get scared. They kind of like look at you and they're kind of like...
I'm gonna beat the shit out of a TV. Oh, it was great. Get some aggression. What,
were you thinking about anything when you were doing it?
Lots of stuff.
We wanted to break like Mercedes, but instead we break a fucking Miata.
Dude, that's just kind of scary. I don't know who's running this show, but I don't think we're really like far enough away. I'm standing in that van, I'm all, it's going higher and higher. I'm all, fuck, one of these tires is gonna bust and come flying right into my nuts or something.
I like to crash the car. I said, hey, can I back up this van into the car we just smashed? And somebody said, yeah. And I smashed up the van. And I smashed it good.
And that was fun. This was a real treat. Like, we weren't, like, doing a gimmick or anything, really. Well, I guess that is a gimmick, but it seemed like we're running naked or making fun of somebody or whatever. We just did something that was just natural and just went around and just had fun. Touring is really, really hard. Touring is hard. You're really tired, you don't sleep. You're up every single night really late and you're sleeping in a bus and you're just wiggling all around.
Typical day on tour is I'd wake up at about probably between 11 in the morning and 1 in the afternoon. I'd get up and I'd immediately start complaining about wanting to go get some Taco Bell.
Marky, you're a pig.
Get the fuck away from my food, dude. Don't even think you're getting a bite of any of this shit either. Go get me another soda.
I don't think there's really much pressure on tour. I like being gone for 3 months playing music every night. It's cool. I'd rather be doing that than sitting at home. I'd get in trouble if I'm at home.
Before shows, I'm always like nervous. I'm usually nervous. I drink 2 to 3 Red Bulls and do a vocal warm-up.
It's not fucking right at all!
I practiced for like, I don't know, like an hour and a half before I played, just to warm up or whatever. I don't know, tons of drummers have a real lot of problems with their hands and they get carpal tunnel and tendonitis, and I just try to avoid all that stuff. And a lot of the times when I'm home, I don't have the time to practice, so I take being on tour and use it as practice time, you know?
On the last tour, it was cool because we'd walk out on stage and the curtain would still be up and they'd start playing the theme music to 2001 Space Odyssey. It was such a cool beginning to the show. I thought it was such a rad beginning. And I loved being behind the curtain, and I loved it when the fuck sign lit up. That every time I saw that, every single night, I'd just start laughing because it was such a cool thing. Such a rush to be on stage and just know that on the other side of the curtain, there's thousands of people waiting to see the show.
This is the part that I fucking hate the most. I just want to go out and play a fucking show.
It's the waiting, right?
It's the waiting. It sucks.
Hey, waiting. Just go do it.
And we're walking on stage and boom, the magic happened.
Huh? $200.
It's fun to have, like, fire and lights.
I think the last tour, the only thing that was going through my head is I had that fire all around me. And at one point, it kind of takes all my oxygen away, and I'm just going, breathe, breathe.
What do you think Kiss was out there doing it? It's fun. There's a couple times where you move and a thing just pops really quick, and you feel the heat just like melt every hair on your body. Remember, go, fuck, I wasn't supposed to go near that part, because on each song, different ones fire, so you really never know which one's going to fire. We almost got burnt. But I was too quick, I was like lightning. It is a broken dream. Aren't you feeling?
just another night alone.
When we're on our off time, me and my wife, we like to order in room service, watch movies, go on the internet, and laugh and stay up late.
Hi, honey. Just getting ready to go on stage. I want to say I love you. And well, really, I was thinking about your boobs, and just like I think you got great boobs, and I love the way your butt looks, and I love you when you're naked.
I'm gonna die.
My wife comes on tour with me. And she watches the shows every night and shakes her head at the terrible jokes and thankfully puts up with me.
She's a road dog. She just hangs. We just mess around. We watch movies and stuff. We do everything that we're supposed to do when we're at home. Kind of touring is a vacation, you know. I get to play drums every day and hang out with her.
It's always fun because we just turn on the TV and laugh and just hang out. And somehow it's like it makes you really, really content.
Will you break something?
Do it. Throw it hard.
Hard.
Yeah! That's my fucking chick! I love you, Jen! I fucking love you so much!
She's not afraid to say tonight's show wasn't as good as last night's. She tries to put a positive on it. Like, last night's show was better. Yeah, last night's show. Rather than saying, man, tonight's show... Sometimes people come on stage, and Brian doesn't like the kids that come up on stage. The stage is our work area. This is where we do our business.
Really, really big guys would take you out and probably hog tie you and slowly tickle your butt with a feather. I remember when we were a smaller band, it was so much fun to have people on stage. I thought it was a lot of fun. They'd make their way up there and they sing with you and stuff. I miss that. I wish that we could still have that. The whole world wants to break in and into our little backstage room and see what's going on. I won't divulge the information.
Fuck shit, fuck shit.
This girl.
Some bitch, you fucking some bitch.
What?
Hey, yeah, that seems like it really worked.
Fuck you.
Ah!
Woo!
Now.
Who am I? Some girls are crazy! Listen to us!
Yes, we did tour with Newfound Glory. They came out on our tour in the summer of 2001. And I got to play a song with them.
Newfound can fucking keep them. Newfound can keep them. I'm looking for a new bass player.
Really?
Just give me a call. 1-800 fucking guys in the ads.
Every time we play a show, we make up bad things, and I'm not happy about it.
We definitely take it too far. It's, you know, it's a contest. We see who can take it the furthest, and then we offend each other, and then we take it back to step one.
Mark said things about me. Uncle Mark shouldn't have said that either, because I'm up here with you, and I don't respect you anymore.
The only people that have ever said that we should stop saying what we say is Congress.
And there's a lot of shit that I said on stage that bummed me out, you know? It's bad, dude, when you say things that bum you out, you know, like, fuck, I shouldn't have said that. I really am disappointed in myself.
You know, kids are smart, and they know that it's all done as a joke, and they know that it's all in good fun. And actually, we make fun of ourselves more than we make fun of anybody else, so, you know what? It's all a joke. There was one time on tour, on the last tour in Oregon. We had a really fun show, and I was really hyper after the show. And for some reason, I thought it'd be fun to go out and throw chips, like crunch up potato chips, and run out and throw it all over everybody that was out there. Threw the chips up in the air, and they landed back on my head. So I ran back in the bus, and I got like a box of waffle mix.
It's waffle mix.
I don't know why that happened exactly. I love the kids that come to the shows, and I do it for you. My favorite part of the show was when the curtain would drop and you'd see all the flashes from all the cameras in the audience. That every night I'd look out and see that and kind of get blown away.
But the shows are a lot of fun. Everything is really, really hard, but that 1.5 hours that we have on stage, it's really fun.
Then we start the set and it's fun. It's really fun. The first day together for the kids was a concept that we've been working on with Sam Bayer for about 2 months before we shot the video. And we thought that a destroyed home would symbolize a home that had been torn apart by divorce.
Their anger hurts my ears.
They spent about 3 days preparing the house. We shot the video the first day, which was September 10th, and then we went back to finish up the small stuff we had to on September 11th, and on the way up there was when all the tragedy went down. In the end, we decided that it wasn't, the images in the video looked too much like the images that were coming back on television from the disaster, so we decided to reshoot the video.
That video was the raddest video, I thought. I thought it was so cool. And I'm glad that we got to be a band that did it, you know?
Like, no matter what you feel, just fucking go kick a hole in something.
I wrote the song specifically about a day when I was 18 years old sitting in my driveway and my parents, my whole family broke on that day. I mean, one day it all went down. It was heavy. It was a really hard time.
See, recording, we usually about anywhere from a month to 2 weeks before we're supposed to go into the studio, we'll start putting our ideas together.
And then Mark and I write songs together with Travis and we'll form the wonderful super trio Blink-182.
So we have basically everything written by the time we go into the studio. And we start with the drums, and then we do guitar, and then we do bass, and then we do vocals, and you just end up spending a lot of time in the studio doing the same thing over and over and over again. It's actually my favorite part of being in a band.
We write and arrange all the music in like 2 weeks, and then we go in and I get my drums done in like 2 days or something, and then I'm finished. Then I go home, and then I come back from time to time and watch the magic happen with, you know, guitars and bass and singing and mixing and stuff.
You see this? Do you see the progress board? These are the songs.
Which one's your favorite?
you know what? It's like your kids, you know? You look at your kids and do you pick favorites? Yes, my favorite's this one. No, I'm just joking. here's the different parts that we have to do. That's what we're working on today, called Shut Up.
I think it's time that I should leave. I think it's time that I should leave. I think it's time that I should leave. I think it's time that I should leave.
It's honestly not a matter of who messes up more, me or Tom, because Tom does mess up more than I do.
You.
Vocals, I usually sing all the songs in like one take, like easily, like in one take. Like sometimes I don't even sing the whole song. I'm so good, like I just sing part of it, and like you don't even. I mean, it's weird when you get really good at singing. It's like you don't even have to sing.
Go fuck yourself.
You're, as long as you're there in the room and you're into the song, that the vocals just flow out and. They make their way and they live on that little tape and they pleasure the ears of kids across the world.
You go on Mark's computer and you hit home button and the very first thing comes up is two hairy guys just fucking and a bear that comes in and they go, fuck, let's go fuck the bear. They go, fuck, let's go fuck the bear. And they're fucking the bear like, ooh, big bear, fucking me. Come on, dude.
You're just a fuck up, she said. I'll live alone instead, she said. I don't care, I know you.
Singing's hard, dude. It's hard to sing in the studio. You never realize like how bad a singer you are. Every time I go into the studio to start cutting vocals, I'm totally humiliated. And actually, I think that singing's the worst part of recording, just because it's on tape how bad you really are as a singer.
I'm never going to come back home. I'll never ask permission from you, fuck off. How did we get through?
Fuck, I hope we get laid this year. Please, God, please. Let me get laid this year. I think this record's seriously going to sell probably 5 or 6 records.
First Date was a video that we shot while we were in Canada, in Vancouver. We shot it over 2 days. It was very hot. There's a lot of different locations. We went to this Canadian water park.
Look at Cheetah checking out the grade A Canadian snatch. All right.
The idea for a First Date video came from Tom watching a Bee Gees documentary, and he called me up real late at night one night and he was dying, he was laughing so hard. He said, dude, we gotta make fun of the Bee Gees, those guys look so ridiculous in their outfits. And so we kind of built the idea of the video from the Bee Gees.
Jack is from England, he's gonna say, in a fortnight, we're going to the Queen's house for tea and crumpets. Go ahead.
In a fortnight, we're going to the Queen's house for tea and crumpets.
When you put on the hair and the fake mutton chops or mustache and that suit, you feel like an absolute idiot.
Oh, First Day was funny. I was hammered when we did that. I drank like 2 bottles of wine just to fuck around because I knew that was a fun video that we could do something like that. So I just drank a whole bunch and acted like... Actually, I didn't act. It's Boomer. That's a real person.
A lot of fucking poontang here, man.
and they hired a bunch of extras, and we shot the video. It was actually a pretty fun video to make. It was pretty easy. We just, you know, basically fucked around for 2 days and threw a video together, and it turned out being what I think is our best video.
Constitution. How do you feel with the articles?
I really don't want to get involved in that.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Hey, the jocks and press that you'd be fucking scumbags. Heavy meathers with their awful pussy hair bands. Counting seconds until we can get away.
There's a reason that Tom and I met, and, you know, we're pretty much the same guy in two different bodies. I feel like we're brothers, and same thing with Travis. When Travis came along, it was the perfect time, and he added something to the band that we never had here before, and he added a dynamic of friendship that I know for a fact that our band would never have gotten to where it is without the three of us finding each other.
Blink-182 to us has always just been three really close friends having a lot of fun.
Being in Blink-182 is... obviously taught me a lot of stuff, you know, about being in a band and just having a good time. It's obviously opened up doors for me to play live shows and just get a chance to play drums and have everyone see my band.
Tom and I have been through everything together. We used to sleep in the van together. We used to sleep on people's floor together. We've been there for each other since day one, and we've gone through everything.
He's full of energy. He's like a little kid. He's just super funny and always has a good time.
He's my best friend, and I'm sure he'll always be my best friend. You know, he's the first person that I think when I find out when something happens, he's the first person that I want to call and tell him about it.
I just have a good time with him. We write well together and walk well together and talk well together. And he's a great friend and a great person to be in a band with.
We would just laugh so hard. We'd make up the stupidest things. And when I'm old, I'll look back to those times and just remember how hard we all laughed.
Mark's and my relationship has grown a lot. He was a nut, and the very first thing he did was climb to a light pole and jumped off it and hurt his ankles and was on crutches for 3 weeks. And I'm like, what is this guy doing? It was really, really weird. We were so alike. We just became best friends and have been that way ever since.
From the day I met him, I remember he was a super nice guy. Really good friend, though, willing to do anything for anybody, and just a good-looking dude.
We just get closer and closer, and we have this really cool communication between us that we can tell each other anything, and we can confide in each other, but then we also feel like we can make fun of everybody, and everyone's different from us, not like we're different from them, and it's pretty cool. It's one of those guys, like, every day you have to talk to somebody, and like every day I have to talk to Mark. If I don't, it's just not the same day.
Travis is just one of my closest friends. Mark and I are both so super stoked and grateful that he's in a band with us.
We were on tour with a band that Travis used to play in, and we needed a drummer because our old drummer Scott, had to leave for the day. That night, he played the set with us, and after the show, Tom and I sat down together and said, this is our drummer. This is the real drummer from Blink-182. And there was never any second thought or any second choice at all. Travis was our friend.
And so we were trying to like figure him out for the longest time, and we did. He's such a great guy, and he's got such a rad personality, and he's so into friendship and so into like being there for his friends and stuff, and it's just been amazing. It made our band so tight to have another guy that we can really share a friendship that was really cool and really strong.
He's always trying to make himself a better musician, a better songwriter, better performer. He practices more than anybody that I've ever met.
Like, you come up with music, and you know, you're like, how many different ways can you make a punk rock song? But there's like 101 ways with Travis.
I mean, aside from being just a really cool guy and one of my best friends, he's probably the best musician that I've ever met. Tom and Travis are my brothers, and I'd do anything for those guys. When all this is said and done, we'll all be together looking back and going, fuck, we made it. You know, this is amazing. How did we do it? I think back even now, even when I walk in on stage and I look out and I see all the people, I get so blown away, and I just think, wow, we made it.
And so many other bands just fight and they don't get along and they hate each other, but when things come down the road that are hard and gnarly, you know, it's just us three, I feel like we can, it doesn't matter, like we don't care, we can do anything.
I think about times when we were traveling in the van and we'd make up stupid songs or we'd make up jokes, and we were so poor back then, we couldn't even barely afford gas to get to the next venue, but we were having so much fun just playing music and being in a band and watching our dreams come true.
I think Mark and Tom will be my friends forever. Fucking friends forever and ever and ever.
We've been through this crazy trip, and we've seen the world, and we've gotten to do all the things that we ever dreamed about, and we've gotten to do it on our own terms.
And I think it's been an amazing trip here, but I think we're going to be one of those bands that's around forever and always makes records, even if nobody's buying them and using them for toilet paper. But we'll still make them because we'll be the best fucking toilet paper anybody's ever used.
I'm sick of always hearing all those sad songs on the radio. All day, it is there to remind an oversensitive guy that he's lost and alone, yeah. I hate our favorite restaurant, our favorite movie, our favorite show. Stay up all through the night, we would laugh and get high and never answer the phone.
This is what Mark does. Hi, I'm Mark. Hi. And then this is Travis.
Hey, I'm Travis.
This is me.
Hey, what's up?
Said this was right.
What are you guys doing to our room?
It stops the door from opening.
I'm excited to play because tonight it's going to be completely light outside and we're going to walk out. The smoke and the flames.
Mark is kissing everybody's ass.
Oh, like you're not.
We're calling people that left us notes of Sombrero.
Hello?
Hi, can I have Mr. Kaznowski, please?
Oh, my God, I don't know.
Who is this?
Oh, my God.
I can't understand what you said. What was that? Hi. I can't hear what you're saying. I'm sorry.
If these kids only know, he calls my house every morning at 7. Hey, what's up, dude?
That's like almost really weird and bad.
This is your dick, Cheetah.
I was gonna be a model for Calvin Klein.
No, you weren't.
You're right, I wasn't.
A bunch of my friends want to know why you never talk about soccer, chicken fighting.
We'll come back and maybe we'll get into some of Corona's better sports.
I'm kicking out their sleigh.